Hey everybody, Jill here. Today I'm going to walk you through the first part of the website audit guide. I'm pretty excited about this. So as I mentioned in the start here page on the audit, I will be doing these tutorials in the order of the sheets. So basics, then technical, then mobile, and so on. I did it in these orders because it makes sense from a perspective of what's most important. So obviously with basics, we want to just get the core things out of the way, make sure that your basics are aligned and that you have a good base to work off of. So we'll start with these basics. Some of you will not need these tutorials. That's fine. Skip through them. Just wait until, you know, the ones that you need come into play. I'm going to try and release as many as I can as quickly as I can. Some things I will go much more into depth than others. Some I'll just kind of go right through. So with that said, I'm going to get started. So today we're just going to cover this basic section up here. And the first two are about Google Analytics. Is Google Analytics installed, including GA4? And is Google Analytics only installed once? Why do these things matter? Is Google Analytics installed? If you are not using Google Analytics, just skip over this. I know some people have kind of started driving away from Google Analytics because of privacy concerns, and then GA4 is causing some issues. So if you don't have it, don't worry about it. Just make sure you have some kind of analytics installed. I know for me, there's two sites that I don't have Google on. I just use GetClicky, which I absolutely love. It's GetClicky.com. It's cheap, it's easy. It gives me all my data without me having to mess with anything. If you have Universal Analytics installed, so basically what that means is if you've had analytics on your site for a few years now, you have not added GA4, you need to add it ASAP. GA4 is going to be the default Google Analytics. Universal is not going to be used anymore. They're going to sunset that. The problem is that the data from Universal Analytics will not be transferred over to GA4. So when you install GA4, you're starting with all new data. You're not going to have historical data. So make sure you're installing that. Google Analytics only installed once. That's an issue. Just it can have some impact on some of the metrics. So we just want to make sure we only have it installed once. So how do we check these items? So for the first one, you can do a manual review of either of these, which requires doing right click and then looking at the source. I'm not going to show you that today. I'm just going to use the tools that I found that should really help you. So SEOsitecheckup.com, if you go to this page, okay, all you have to do is just put in your URL and click checkup, and it'll tell you if you have it installed. So I put my Two Dogs Media site in, and you can see it's telling me Google Analytics test. This page is using Google Analytics. So I know that it is finding analytics on my site. I can come back here, I can put good, and we are good to go. Is Google Analytics only installed once? This one's a little trickier now because you could have Google Analytics installed with a plugin. You can have it installed with manual code, like you pull the script right from Google, or you can be using Tag Manager. So there's a couple different ways to look for it. What I like is the Google Debugger Chrome extension. So when you download this, you put it right into your Chrome browser, and this is what it looks like up here. It's a little envelope, and you can see if I hover over it, it says GA Debug On, which means it's ready to go. I can go to my website. Okay, and while I'm on my website, just wanna make sure it still says On. I'm gonna right click and click Inspect. So you go to your website, right click, click Inspect, and then go to Console. When you scroll up, you'll see Google Tag. So I'm using the Google Tag Manager to insert my analytics code, and it's only here once. So I only see that big giant Google tag once. If you're using Universal Analytics, it might say Google Analytics, and it might have like .js after it in these big giant letters. You just want to make sure you're only seeing it once. Okay, so that's how you can double check. The other way you can find out if you have it installed more than one time, typically it will be a problem for your bounce rate. That is the most common thing. So I've had, over the years, I've had many clients be like, oh my God, my bounce rate's only 3%, and they're all excited. And I'm the one who has to be the bearer of bad news and tell them that's not real. It's because you have two Google Analytics installed. So if you're seeing ridiculously low bounce rates, it's probably because you have two analytics installed. So that's another way to double check. So let's do this as good. So we know that's good. Is Search Console set up? Really important, guys. I would like to think most of you do have it set up. If you don't, please do it ASAP. If you need instructions, hit me up. I'll see if I can find a tutorial or I'll try and do a quick one for you. If you go to this website, okay, search.google.com/search-console, while you're logged into your Google account, you should be taken to a Google Search Console page and your website should be showing here. So we can see here, I have this one. I have all my sites in here, okay, but I just loaded this one. Okay, so that's how you can double check. You want to make sure you have this because I am going to review a bunch of stuff in Search Console later in this audit training. So that's good. Is a custom 404 page in place? Usability is everything these days. So whenever you're thinking about anything on your site, think about usability. A 404 page is really helpful for a user. Okay, so what you want to do, just go to your website. You can just type in anything. Anything that's not a page that exists on your website. I put in Why Me. This is the page. This is my 404 page, and it's horrible. So I will work on this at some point. I just haven't had the time. But I would like to improve it. I'll improve the search box. I may add some links to some of the most important pages that people might be looking for. The best thing is to make sure you don't have any 404 pages, which we'll dive into that later in the audit. But in the off chance that you do, make sure your 404 page is customized. So I wanted to show you what HubSpot did. Okay, something really simple. We're heartbroken, we missed you. Doesn't look like there's a page here. Here's some things that maybe I'll help you find what you're looking for. Could be that simple. Okay. So you definitely want to add that to your list of things to do. So I'm going to put poor because I didn't do it well. Is the server location local to your visitors? So this matters for mostly speed reasons. Imagine you're taking a car ride and you want to go from New Jersey to California. So you want to take the most straight route there. You don't want to go from New Jersey to China to California because that would be kind of silly. Well, that's exactly what this check does. It's just making sure people are getting to your site in the quickest way possible. This is a user experience signal, a speed signal. So it's kind of important to know where your server is located. Your server is where you're basically hosting. So if we check at checkhost.net, which is this website, I already opened it. I put in my website. We can see my IP address at my host is this, and it's telling me it's pulling out of New Jersey, okay, which is where I'm located. So although I have visitors from all over the country, a lot of my visitors are from New Jersey because I'm local here. So there is a balance of, you know, being able to have the whole country visiting your site and the local. So I wanted something that was close to me. I host with Cloudways, which allows you to choose the area that you're in, which is why it's showing pretty accurately. The next thing you want to check is I'm going to take this IP address, which is my server address, and I'm going to go to reverse IP. Okay. This is the next check. So we now know that my server location is in New Jersey. Now I want to check who else is on my server with me. Okay. Now if I put either Two Dogs Media or the IP address in here, this is what I get. Okay. So this is it. These are the sites that are on my server with me. And what this is telling me, I have my own server. So all these sites on here are actually mine. So you want to make sure that you're not on a server with a lot of spammy domains. So I did another poll of just another website, totalshape.com. You can see there's 629 domains on this IP address. Okay, and look at the different types. Okay, so .ch, .it, .de, and .l. These are all different domains that are sharing the same server. The concern is going to be when you're really starting to dig in to the people that are hosting with you. If you see a lot of porn sites or drug sites, Viagra and all of those, those can really be spammy websites, which can negatively affect you just by association. Okay, so you just want to make sure that you're kind of on a server that's got some good people on it. In the past, I found a lot of issues with GoDaddy sites, you know, because there's thousands of websites on the same servers, and you're with whatever they want to put on that server. So you just want to be careful with that. And this is a good way to let you see who's on that server with you. So these are definitely two important checks. So I'm going to put good for both of mine. And then, does the site use subdomains? So this you might already know. You might not have to do any checks for it. But you can use Screaming Frog or Sitebulb, or there's also this website I found where you can just put in, I'm actually going to do HubSpot here because I know they do have subdomains. Site contains .hubspot.com, and then if I click search, and if it was your domain, you'd put .mydomain.com. So now this is going to tell me all of the subdomains that HubSpot has. Okay, so knowledge.hubspot, which is probably their knowledge base. Okay, so these are all separate domains. Why does this matter? Sometimes we have found that clients will have subdomains they don't even know exist, and those subdomains might be fighting with content with the main site. So it's really important to make sure you're doing subdomains the right way, using them for the right reasons. Most of you probably will not have subdomains, but it's an important check to do, especially if you bought the site, or you know, maybe there was a previous owner, the company got bought. There's so many different reasons. So it's just a check I always do just to make sure there's nothing funny going on. So I know I do not have any, so I'm just going to put good. And the last one we're going to go through today is just the favicon. Okay, and that's this little picture up here. Okay, the reason why the favicon is important is because it will show up in the bookmark up here. It will show up in the title tag next to the title tag. Sometimes it will show up in search. Google kind of tests things out sometimes. And also because when people bookmark your site, it's easy to find if the favicon is in there. So when you're looking through, you know, really busy bookmarks, you know, you can see all the different icons easily. So it's just more of a brand thing than an SEO thing, but still important. So that is it for this episode. Stay tuned for the benchmarks and WordPress, which I hope to release later this week, and we're gonna get going. So I hope this was easy. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments on the video, and I look forward to getting to the next section for you. Have a great day, everyone.